So I want to share my heart with you today. Listen closely. One of the signs that God is not answering prayers in the Bible is when God shuts the heaven and there will be no rain. And God said it over and over again. When my people sin against me, I will shut the heavens and there shall be no rain. But do you know the first sign of God's favor upon the land? He will open the heavens and there shall be rain. And I'm standing here with the intensity of this prophecy increasing, that I want to speak with every fiber of my being. Get ready. Every blessing of an open heaven is about to come upon your lives. Can I get a witness here? If you believe when God opens the heavens, things will change. Can you give a Lord a praise in the house of the Lord? Things will change. But I want everybody who is going to listen to this message today, have a prayer, maybe go write it down, and I'm going to do that for myself. Lord, help me to believe. One line. Lord, give me grace to believe. Because it's important. Unbelief can cost you this blessing. But let's pray for faith. I want to bring a story in that light. 2 Kings chapter 7 and verse number 1 onwards. Let's read that. I want to bring some brief points and I'm done for today. But Elisha said, hear the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord, tomorrow about this time a sea of fine flour shall be sold for a shekel and 2 seahs of barley for a shekel at the gate of Samaria. Then the captain on whose hand the king leaned said to the man of God, this is the advisor, the main guy, if the Lord himself should make windows in heaven, could this thing be? Please do not limit God because of your circumstances. I'm going to be very open today. You know, there comes a point in everybody's life that you look forward for God to do things. But when things don't happen, the timing that you expected and the way you expected, there comes a resignation, a sense of what may be. There's no point. Even your expectation becomes a casualty. But I've got one word for you. In this season, things can happen suddenly and supernaturally. So we need to believe our God can do it. Our God can do it. Let expectation come back into your lives, into your family. If you believe that, shout a hallelujah in the house. You know, I'm not preaching today from the privileged position of a platform. I'm going to be your family member. I'm going to stand beside you this afternoon. And I want to just nudge you, just embrace you and say, brother, sister, do not give up hope. Because God is on the move. You know why this passage is so important? Let me give you one word. My friend Ajay from California was here a couple of weeks back. He went back on Sunday morning. But on Saturday evening, we had a meeting in a house. Susan is here. Just wave your hand. In our house. So Ajay, in the afternoon, he went into the presence of the Lord and he prayed for this church. He expected to get some time to speak that night, but didn't happen. But he was praying, saying, God, give me a word. And he said, Pastor, I've not had this every time, but I can remember 3 or 4 times that I've heard his voice. And as I was praying, the Lord told me, this is a verse for this church. I'm opening the windows of heaven. And there's going to be rain from this story. See, he was debating, God, is this from you? And the Lord told him, just like Gideon when he went to the enemy's camp, he heard the same dream, same thing repeated through a dream. He heard it. The Lord said, when you go to the meeting today, somebody will confirm it. So he went to the meeting, and Susan, just before I could preach, stood up and sang a Malayalam song. And the song was, "He's opening the windows of heaven." And this is the passage. And I'm here to confirm that God can turn things around just like that. If somebody believes in the power of God to do it, can you put your hands together, give the Lord a praise? He can turn things around just like that, suddenly and supernaturally beyond human imagination or comprehension. He can do it. I believe he can do it. He can do it. Now listen carefully. Look what happens if you do not believe. If the Lord himself should make windows in heaven, could this thing be? But he said, the prophet said, you shall see it with your own eyes, but you shall not eat of it. I don't want a move to happen in this church and people to fall through the crack. I've been telling Pastor Dino and my friends over and over again, there will be a move. And I don't want one family to miss out on it, to forfeit it, to squander it away. And how many of you want to say, God, when you send that rain, I want to be blessed. My family need to be blessed. If you believe that, can you make it known in the house of the Lord? I don't want to miss out on it, Lord. I want to partake of that blessing in the name of Jesus. But what was the reason? You know what happens with many of us? When God says something to us, you know, we have a certain imagination based on our own experience as to how it should happen. But most of the time, God surprises us. And we have a certain way we expect it to happen. And I heard the Lord telling me today morning, when my people expect one way, and when that one way does not happen, they get disappointed. Tell my people, when they were expecting one way, I have thousands of ways to do a miracle in their lives. Can somebody take, for instance, what would be the expectation of this people? The expectation is suddenly, dramatically, the heavens will open up and suddenly cones and things will start to fall from heaven. Maybe that's what they expect, the windows of heaven. But that's not the way God did. Look at the way he did it. Providence kicked in. Next verse. Keep reading. Let's read. Now there were 4 men who were lepers. You don't expect lepers to be the instruments of your miracle. But God can use the weakest to confound the strongest. He can use the foolish to confound the wise. When God says a miracle, a move, you don't expect a leper. Let me tell you, when God says a revival in Canada, you don't expect a man from India. God has his people. The least that you expect for his move. These were lepers, and they were sitting at the entrance of the gate, and they said to one another, why are we sitting until we die? If we say, let us enter the city, the famine in the city, and we shall die there. If we sit here, we die also. So now come. What's the point? Let us go over to camp of Syrians. If they spare our lives, we shall live, and they kill us, we shall but die. I heard in my spirit, some of you make a determination. There's no point to doubt. There's no point not to believe in God. There's no point in continuing in the sense of resignation. Can you make a decision? I'm going to try him. If I die, I die. But I'll die believing him. Can I get some witness in the house of the Lord? I'm making a decision over here. God, you know, I'm not going. That's, if you think doubting God and disbelieving Him, despair, coming to a point of resignation is a way forward. If you think that, I've got a news for you. I've never seen anybody who has received things through despair and doubt and by distrusting God. I'm asking you today, for once, can you say, Lord, the reasons are compelling. The situations are so bad, but I choose to. Come on. Now, can I hear a response in this house? Anybody willing to say, I choose to believe my God? Come on, I choose to believe my God. In spite of what I'm going through, in spite of my situation, I choose to believe my God. If that's your decision, can you make it known in the house of the Lord? I choose to believe my God. Come on, get ready, get ready, get ready. I have no other way. Believe me, Anison has no other way out of it. I need him. And these people said, if you die, we die. But what's the point of living a life without trying? Let me try and die. Next verse. So they arose at twilight to go to the camp of the Syrians, but when they came to the edge of the camp of the Syrians, behold, there was no one there. So therefore the Lord had made the army of the Syrians hear the sound of chariots and of horses. Truly heaven opened up. But this time, God did not send corn and wheat from heaven like he sent manna. He sent a sound. We don't even know how God does when he opens the heaven. If he has to send manna, he will do it. If he has sent rain, he will do it. But if he has sent a sound over your family, he is about to send the sound to terrify the powers of evil. Come on, somebody, let God open the heavens. Come on, somebody. Oh, how many of you believe even if God sends a sound from heaven, my family will be set free? If you believe that, can you give? Now, let me ask you once again. How many of you really believe even if God sends a sound from heaven, that will change my situation? If you believe that, can you give God a sound of faith? He sends the sound of a great army. So that say, they said to one another, please read. Please read. Said one to another. So they fled away in the twilight. Okay. Hear sound of chariots and the story goes on. And they tried to keep it because the camp got deserted when they heard the sound. They thought, you know, the army is attacking them. They just heard the sounds of chariots and God just, you know, what did he do? He manufactured the sound of horses and chariots and brought delusion in the enemy's camp. He didn't even have to do anything. A sound. Now let me tell you, we all have believed, God, if you touch me, I will be set free. And some of you believe beyond that. If you speak a word, I will be set free. But today, is anybody to push it further? You don't even have to speak a word. A sound. Now, can I hear the people who believe there's power in the sound from heaven? If you believe that, come on. There's a sound coming over your family. A sound coming over your children. A sound coming over Edmonton. A sound coming over your little ones. The sound from heaven. Receive it in the name of Jesus. They left everything. And these lepers, when they saw that, they were very happy. They collected as much. They went and hid everything they could. Finally, common sense dawned on them. They said, what's the point of us keeping everything? We are lepers. We don't need so much money. They were not selfish. They wanted others to get the news. Now, I've got a word over here. When this revival happens, how many of you want a few more people to get this news? Now, can I ask you to do something today? Because it's an act of faith. We are moving forward. I've never done this before, this manner. I want to take a 10 seconds. If there is an empty seat beside you, can you touch that empty seat and say, God, I release people over here. Come on. Speak it out. Speak it out. Don't leave any empty seat without being touched. It's your responsibility. If you have started getting a taste of the move of God, touch the empty seat because the news is going to spread. Make sure that you have touched all the seats. Can somebody, Auntie Molly standing outside, can you release that foyer? Because people are standing out there. Come on. These lepers decide to release the news. And I'm here to say, the news of the sound from heaven, scattering the powers of evil, is about to come upon Edmonton. If you can believe that, can I hear a resounding sound from the church? A sound of victory is coming in the name. That's the windows of heaven. Oh, Rabba, Rabba, Hantala, Rabba, Shante. If you believe there's a sound coming over your family that's going to scatter the powers of evil, can you lift up your voice and blow the trumpet in the house of the Lord? There is a sound of victory coming. Oh, hallelujah. Hey, get ready. And I want to bring two words and I'm done. Next week I'll continue preaching. I want to bring two words. And this is what the Lord told me. So they got it. And verse number, can you read? You know, I skipped some passages. Can you read verse number 16 onwards? 16. Then the people went out and plundered the camp of the Syrians. So a sea of fine flour was sold for a shekel. When God says something, we have a way of speculating, articulating, imagining, but God used four lepers. I tell you, for the sake of our building, who knows God is going to use? But they're coming. I said they're coming. Somebody give the Lord an amen. They're coming. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Exactly enough what the Lord told me today. And I'm going to give you a few seconds of an exercise. It was done according to the word of the Lord. And I heard it very clear. Tell my people, things are going to happen not as according to what the devil said, not as according to your circumstances, not as according to as you imagined, but according to the word of the Lord. And the Lord told me, over every situation, my word is about to get preeminent. Now, I want you to take a few seconds, for those of you who believe, what God said in my life is what's going to happen to me. If you believe according to what God said, if you believe that, can you make an expression over here? Not what the devil said. Not what the enemy is saying. Not what your sense is saying. Not what the circumstance is saying. But what God said over my family, over my children, is what is going to happen. If you believe that, can you give a Lord a faith offering of praise? Come on. A faith. Yes, yes. Come on, give a Lord. Give it up. Give it up. A faith offering of praise according exactly as the Lord said. When you did that, you know, I'm being very sensitive to the Holy Spirit this morning. While you did that, I sense in my spirit, I saw like arrows, providence started to kick in. Right now, things are coming into place. So can we do it a little more stronger? Can you go run to somebody, shake hands, say, it'll happen exactly as what the Lord said. Speak it out. Exactly as what God said. You're releasing faith. You're releasing faith. exactly as the Lord said. You're releasing faith. We are going to stop here. You're releasing faith. Speak it out, speak it out, speak it out. I want faith to increase. Faith. Don't miss out on this move of God. Faith. Exactly. It takes only one move of God. One sound from heaven. Situations will change. But come on. Don't speak with a grumpy, frowny face. Come on. Speak with joy in your face. It'll happen exactly. Exactly as what God said. You know, when that man, the captain, said it wouldn't, God said you won't take part in it. But when you said it will, God said you will take part in it. So today, your family will take part in it. Yeah. Your life will take part in it. If you believe that, can you give a Lord a praise in the house of the Lord? Come on, get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready. In the name of Jesus. I'm going to pray and close here. I'm going to close here. But you know what? I heard it in my spirit very loud and clear this morning. I want to release that and then we pray and close. What so touched me was these words. It will be done. This sea or this, you know, the famine was so bad. If you read the previous chapter, they were bargaining whose baby to cook and eat. That's how bad it was. But God is reversing it with one word. And then it says, at the gate, I like that word. At the gate, it will happen. Do you know what? In the Bible, God had given Israel a promise to Abraham. You will possess the gates of your enemy. But you know what happened? Now the enemy has taken over the gate of Israel. What is a gate? Gate is a place where transactions happen. Transactions about your children, about marriage, about business, about future plans, decisions and counsels happen at the gate. I can prove it anytime. You know, when the Bible says the king sat at the gate, that's a very important statement, meaning now transactions are going to happen. But why couldn't they have transactions at the gate? Because the enemy had besieged the gate. And the Lord told me to tell you, it's not just the coming of barley, but the Lord told me to tell you, the gates where transactions should have happened in your life, which was locked by the devil, is reopening. If you believe that, put your hands together. Come on, lift up your voice. The transactions. I mean transactions of business. Transactions of ministry. Transactions about your children. Transactions about marriages are going to happen in the name of Jesus. Are you ready to receive the gate? Oh, I can sense the anointing. Everybody in this place, if you have observed that no significant transactions have happened in your life for the last few years, lift up your hand right now. We are releasing you in the name of Jesus. Whether it's your ministry, whether it's your future, whether it's your children, whether it's your business, no proper transactions are happening. The gate is almost deserted. And I heard the Lord tell me the next move of God is at the gate, meaning transactions, buying and selling and receiving and giving are going to take place at the gate. Pray, 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 pray. I'm going to release it upon your life. How many of you want transactions to happen in your family? Lift up both of your hands. This church needs transactions to happen, including the transactions of buildings. But the gate where transactions must happen has been taken over by the Syrians, by the enemy. Major things that were supposed to happen in your family has been held back, stuck. But I'm here to declare in the name of Jesus Christ, because of an open heaven that God promised, from this day onwards, your gate of transactions is coming back to you. If you believe that, can you make a noise to heaven right now as a noise of faith? Come on, somebody, receive it in the name of Jesus. Transactions, 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 transactions in the name of Jesus. Pray, pray, pray. You know, while we're doing this, I sense a significant prophetic act coming into the midst. If you have a pen, if you have got anything that will describe a transaction being made, do an action. I don't know how you do transactions. Signatures, council, conference, meeting, shaking hand. But this gate has been held by the enemy. And I heard the Lord telling me today, I'm releasing the gate. Transactions are going to happen in your family. Not just natural transaction, supernatural. The Lord said, at the gate, this will be released. You know what? It's so strange. It's at the gate that this captain got killed. The captain who said he won't believe it. He died at the gate. Today, it's not death at the gate, but transactions. Are you ready? Are you ready? If you want this to happen by faith, do something that signifies your personal faith in this promise of God. Maybe move, maybe lift up your hand. Do whatever you can as an act of faith. I'm going to pray for you. There are families where the gate has never seen a transaction for many years. Your promise is this: you will possess the gates of the enemy. But the enemy seemed to have taken over. But today the promise of God is the gates of hell shall not prevail against the church of a living God. So I declare transactions at the gate in the name of Jesus. You know what I'm going to do? I'll be stepping forward by faith as a sign that I'm moving forward with transactions. Yes. Oh, accounts. Okay, transactions. Transgressions to transactions. Yes. Let me pray. Father, you told me very clearly this morning that the gates of transactions are coming back to your people. That every month, things will happen. Every week, things will happen. Every day, things will happen. The lockdown is over. The shutdown is over. Transactions are happening in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. As a servant of a living God, I declare and I decree from this day onwards, no more lockdowns, no more shutdowns at the gate. But because of an open heaven, there's going to be transactions. There is going to be spread of transactions in the name of Jesus. And Lord, every demonic powers that had crowded around, that had come and taken over the gate, I am releasing a word today in the name of Jesus. The sound of heaven, the chariots of heaven, the horses of heaven, the angels of heaven are going to scatter the enemy. Hallelujah! 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 Transactions, financially, spiritually, children's life, marriages, birth of children, in the name of Jesus. No more shutdown gates, no more lockdown gates, but gates of transactions. Released, released in the name of Jesus. And those of you who believe that, shout an amen. Hey, you know what? I'm releasing the gates of transaction for my life in the name of Jesus. If you want that, do something and praise God. Just do something. Hallelujah. Woo! Bless you. Bless you. Ha. You know what? I had a season in my life where every day I had new things happening. House, church, you know, ministry, new country. And something tells me, get ready, Anison. The gate of transaction is coming down. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.